Welcome back, friends, or if you're new to my channel, hi there, I'm Karina. I'm a fitness and health enthusiast, lifestyle blogger, recipe developer, chronic pain sufferer with multiple medical conditions, and soon-to-be holistic nutritionist. Today is extra special for me because I'm going to be giving you a peek into my family's life. More importantly, though, I'm going to be giving you a glimpse into my daughter's life and what it's been like for her since she was diagnosed with a very aggressive autoimmune disease only a few months ago. Our lives were forever changed, but my little one seems to be following in her mother's footsteps and showing everyone around her that although life may be different, there's absolutely no reason to stop living or doing what you love. Before I dive into the bulk of today's vlog, though, I want to give you a little bit of McKenna's history and how we were led to today.
McKenna absolutely fell in love with volleyball a few years ago. Because both myself and her dad played the sport, we were beyond excited when she picked up a ball and actually enjoyed learning the game. Not only that, she was good, really good. This year, she made the Junior Olympic National Volleyball Team, which is highly competitive. The season runs for 6 to 8 months. They train 3 days per week with traveling tournaments 1 to 2 times a month. You can understand how devastated we were when she was diagnosed with Still's disease or systemic juvenile idiopathic arthritis this past January. One day out of the blue, her joints just began to swell. She was struck with daily high fevers, widespread body rashes, extreme fatigue, and could barely muster up the energy to get out of bed each morning. Literally overnight, the girl we had known for 11 years was gone, and she would never be the same. This was easily the most difficult time in all of our lives. We were scared, we were confused, we were angry, and we certainly didn't know what the future was going to bring. Luckily though, she was diagnosed very early on after the initial onset, probably within 4 weeks or so. She was seen by every doctor you could think of, and once her diagnosis was confirmed, she was able to begin very aggressive treatment. Within the first few days of her daily injections, fevers reduced, joint pain and swelling decreased, and her rashes began to fade. Initially, it was extremely difficult for us to adjust to this new life, but here we are 3 months later, and we now have a new normal in our lives. Although McKenna struggles with minor symptoms here and there, she's so much better, and we definitely could not keep her off the volleyball court. Here's a glimpse of a typical tournament day for our family now. As usual, with my prepping and planning, it begins at least one day before the actual event. McKenna doesn't necessarily like eating at 5 a.m. in the morning when we leave, but will usually want something closer to the time we arrive at the tournament. 9 times out of 10, I'll make her a yogurt parfait because it's something she can eat on the go and doesn't have to get warmed up. All I need to do is throw some yogurt in a mason jar with some fruit, and then I pack along some granola in a Ziploc baggie that she can dump in just before she's ready to eat. Screw on the lid, keep it in the fridge, and grab it in the morning as we head out the door. Her breakfast is usually eaten some point along the drive up to Orange County. Because I practice intermittent fasting, for the first few hours after I wake up, I'm normally just drinking herbal tea. I usually have about 40 ounces by 10:30, 11 a.m. or so. So the typical breakfast isn't really needed for me to eat. When I'm done with my tea, I usually technically break my fast with my own version of bulletproof decaf coffee. Here, I'm getting it all lined up in the morning, so all I have to do is make a fresh batch once I wake up. Most people who do bulletproof add coconut oil and butter. I do 2 cups of decaf, 2 teaspoons of homemade ghee, coconut oil, or MCT oil, stevia, 1 scoop of collagen, which is great for your joints, your hair, skin, and nails, 1/2 scoop of glutamine, which is an essential amino acid, which is good for digestive and brain health, muscle growth, and athletic performance. Sometimes I'll add some L-carnitine also, which is great to combat fatigue and just gives you a little bit of energy in the morning. For mornings, I need to have stuff ready like before a tournament. I typically just throw the powders into a little plastic container. Then in the morning, all I have to do is throw it all into a blender and then put it in my Hydro Flask to drink later on in the day. Because we never know when the tournament is going to be over or how long it's going to be, I pack at least one meal for myself. For this tournament, I did leftovers, which is pretty typical for me for my first meal anyways. Here we have a big bed of greens, romaine, lettuce, and arugula. Then I added some chicken and veggies from the previous night's dinner. I topped it off with some homemade pesto sauce, which was also leftovers. I stored it in the fridge, and it's ready to go for me to grab in the morning. I also like to pack myself some quick snacks or extra protein in case I'm in a pinch to nibble on something. Usually these things only come in handy when I'm bored, because when you eat keto, you typically never find yourself really hungry. Insulin levels remain steady and constant throughout the entire day, but I am a huge snacker, so you can typically find me chomping on a little something here and there. For this tournament, I packed up some olives, some sachi inchi seeds, which I got from Trader Joe's, and some soaked and sprouted almonds and pumpkin seeds I had from my previous week's meal prep. The last bit of food stuff is my eating out kit. It's tradition for us to head to a restaurant once the tournament is over. Eating out on keto is extremely easy, but when you have severe food intolerances, it's a bit more difficult. I usually just bring along a salad dressing, some ghee or coconut oil to pour over my steamed vegetables, barbecue sauce, and some Thousand Island dressing. The last few things I'll get ready to go are my supplements, vitamins, and herbs. Most importantly are the digestive enzymes that both McKenna and I take. Over 80% of our immunity is in our stomachs, so you can always catch me doing whatever I can to improve digestion and gut health. I do chewable ginger, which helps when you're feeling a bit nauseous or your stomach is just uneasy. Next is HCL, which McKenna and I both take before each meal. Bromelain is from pineapples, and it's known to reduce swelling and inflammation, so it's really great for McKenna's JA. I also take 50 milligrams of 5-HTP each morning. This supplement helps balance out serotonin levels. It's also great for anyone suffering from sleep issues, fatigue, or even depression, anxiety, tension headaches, and also fibromyalgia. Magnesium glycinate helps with energy levels, can help control muscle spasms, helps regulate neurotransmitter receptor sites in our brains. Ubiquinol is an active form of coenzyme Q10, which is a powerful antioxidant. And last, if I'm ever feeling really stressed out or anxious, I may end up taking some holy basil as well. It's also great for anyone suffering from adrenal fatigue or have cortisol levels that are kind of all over the place. Once everything is prepped and ready to go, I just lay everything out on the kitchen counter the night before. So in the morning when I wake up, all I have to do is go down my little assembly line. I fill the water bottles, make my tea, make my coffee, put those in the hydro flasks. Then I just grab the food from the fridge, put it in the Fitmark bag, and we can head out the door to Orange County. My husband will then get the truck ready. I can't tell you how much this inflatable bed has helped our car rides. There was a time where I couldn't sit for longer than a few minutes at a time, so driving anywhere was completely out of the question. Now though, I just weave myself in and out of the seatbelts, and I'm good to go with pain-free driving for as long as it takes in the car. Disclaimer here, before anyone says anything, yes, we are aware this isn't the most safe when driving, but I'm pretty locked in with the 3 seatbelts, and really, the alternative is me missing the tournament or being in extreme pain before the day even starts, so I choose to take the risk, and we take the necessary precautions as much as we can. We'll be right back.
Hi guys, so here we are. This is our final volleyball tournament of the regular season, which lasts about 6 to 7 months. I'm kind of bummed that I didn't start the YouTube channel a long time ago, or at least earlier in the season, because it would have been really interesting to see how things have changed. I wanted to vlog today though, because I feel like we have finally, at the end of the season, gotten all of the organizing and planning and prepping for today down to a science. You wouldn't necessarily think that so much thought goes into the day, but it definitely does. When you live in a home with two people that have chronic illnesses, you honestly never know what each day is going to bring. Each day is, it could be different, it could be the same, but you definitely have to be prepared for anything. I'm ready to head inside. McKenna is already warming up, so let's head on in. Game one is officially done for the day. The girls killed the other team. It wasn't even it was like a practice game. I think the first game was like 5-25. The second one was 8-25 or something like that. So it was definitely an easy win for them, which is good because McKenna is struggling a little bit today. For the past few weeks, she's had rashes have been coming back, and we're not sure what they're from. She's seen the allergist already, she sees dermatology on Tuesday, and then the following week she'll see rheumatology. So for right now, I needed to head back to the car to grab some hydrocortisone, and I am very thankful that we have it today, because there have been other tournaments where she's had rash or joint pain or something and needed one of the braces. So just back in the car right now to grab that ointment and hopefully have her feeling better. So, all right, on to game two. Our second game, and the girls did so awesome, and yeah, the girls killed it. I just came back to the car and I'm getting ready to eat my first meal. It is 12:20 right now. This is one of the reasons why I love intermittent fasting, is because it's 12:20. I haven't had any meals today, totally not hungry. I could probably go another hour, two, if I really wanted to, but we're probably gonna go out to eat after this, so I wanna at least be hungry when we go to the restaurant. So I'm just gonna get this meal out of the way, not because I have to, but it's nice not having to worry about that many meals. I just pack one meal and some snacks if I need to, and I'm good to go. So anyways, just checking in. I'm gonna eat this and then head back in for our final game. So meal one for the day. I know it looks a little weird, but this is just leftovers from last night. I have some greens, some sauteed vegetables. I think there's yellow squash, zucchini, onions, mushrooms, and then there's chicken underneath somewhere there, and then homemade pesto sauce. So anyways, gonna eat this and head back in. Totally tried just eating my first meal and I couldn't. I wasn't even hungry, so I had a few bites, and instead I'm gonna go ahead and snack on these. Just a little bit. We should be done here in maybe 45 minutes, and then we're gonna go head to a restaurant and eat. So I'm good to go waiting. So tournament is all done, and while I do love watching McKenna play, I am extremely thankful that it's over, because I don't know, maybe an hour and a half ago my body was basically like put on the brakes and was like, nope, you're done. You are done for the day. You have pushed it. So I am officially worn out. We are gonna be grabbing something to eat. That will be my first meal of the day. And then we're gonna head back to San Diego. Today wasn't a typical eating day at a tournament. I normally eat at least one of the meals that I bring. But today I wasn't hungry at all. I had a really hard night, and then the adrenaline was going this morning because the girls were doing so well. And I just didn't feel like eating. So, but the good news about not eating, not being hungry earlier, is that I can have really big meals for the rest of the day. So, excited about that. Gonna go and eat some islands and then have those snacks on the way home. And then tonight for dinner, I can have a really, really huge meal plus a dessert, maybe even a double dessert. So yeah, tournament is done. The girls end up finishing in second. So that was awesome. They did good and I'm proud of them. So McKenna she had kind of a rough day, especially the beginning of the day and the very end of the day. She had some stomach pains from the injection this morning in the game that we just finished. You could see her on the court kind of grabbing her stomach and kind of wincing with pain. But she's a trooper and she pulled through it. And yeah, definitely always proud of her. And then this morning was rough for her, and she still has rashes all over her neck. This morning she had a couple on her face. So I'm kind of looking forward to what the next doctors that we see, what they say about the rash. Hopefully it's not disease related and it's just some weird fluke thing. So that's what we're crossing our fingers for anyways. All right, we are off to islands.